everybody. My name is Lorraine Murray. As you can see from here, I am the founder of the programme Connected Kids, and we are all about helping adults learn meditation for themselves as well as sharing it with the young people in their lives too, whether that's for personal reasons or to become a trained, accredited professional meditation teacher. Now, I'm going to share with you one of the tools that we use in our professional training, and this is just a short introduction. So for those of you that are curious about our professional training, we go into this in much more depth, but I really wanted to give you a flavour of it today because it's one of my favourite meditation tools. And the tool I'm going to show you is a labyrinth. Now, this labyrinth is made out of oak, and usually the ones that people use are either walking labyrinths or perhaps they are paper versions. And as you can see, there is a pattern to it. And the idea is that you start on the outside and you work your way into the centre. And then once you've finished, you make your way back out again. I've written about this with the help of Reverend Di Williams, who's an expert in labyrinths, in my second book, Connected Kids. So you might want to get a copy of that, actually. So how can you use this for your meditation practice? Well, one of the ways you can use it is to actually start the journey into the centre and to set an intention of it opening you up to creativity, to new ideas, and to opportunities as well. And it helps us open up our energy in a heart-centered way so that we can embrace new ideas and opportunities throughout our day. If we're using it at the beginning of the meditation practice, just on its own, then you might find you get some really valuable insights in your meditation practice. And then at the end of the day, or the end of your meditation practice, you then come back out to the labyrinth. So you follow the path out. And that just has an amazing effect on your energy and helps you to feel grounded and supported and safe, and to maybe help manifest some of the amazing ideas or insights that you were aware of during your day or the meditation practice. Now, if you are with a young person, then this is a really nice tool to use. And it's one of my favourite tools to help particularly young people on the autistic spectrum. I suppose it looks like a puzzle. So sometimes there is that desire to complete the puzzle. But the thing about a labyrinth is that it's not a maze. So there is no chance of getting lost. It's really about a one way in path and a one way out. And if you are familiar with sacred geometry or the background to labyrinths, you'll know that even without any mindful approach to it, it can be a very interesting meditation tool for young people to use. It can really settle their energy. Now, obviously, I have this lovely wooden one, but you can easily look for labyrinth designs on the internet and just print them off and get a young person to follow that. So I hope that's been helpful, and my suggestion is before you let your young person use one, you try it first and see the effect it has for you. Let me know in the comments how you got on or if you've any questions, and if you're curious about actually learning to use this tool in a more in-depth way with us through our professional training, then please check out our website, connectedkids.com, where we've got lots of information about that, your accredited certified course.
And we also have
a payment plan now, so it makes it a little bit easier for people to access. Have a wonderful day.